Hello everyone, my name is Infinity, and this is Magnetize Yourself, where we talk about life, love, spirituality, and of course, the law of attraction. If you hear some sounds in the background, I do apologize in advance. It is raining, so you might hear the rain on the window, but hopefully that won't be too distracting during the reading, or maybe even a little bit soothing. So I am now shuffling my energy oracle cards deck. As I'm sure you know from the title of this video, this is a twin flame reading. So just to clarify, this reading is specifically intended for twin flames or divine counterparts, divine love relationships. And today I really want to shuffle the cards for a little while so that I can fully clear out any past energies. And as I said, that one card already fell out. And really bring forth clear messages for all of you who are listening. Which, by the way, if you would like me to channel specific messages for you and your connection, be sure to subscribe to this channel and to like the video. Because by taking those two actions, by liking and subscribing, you are actually virtually sending your energy wherever you are on the planet, whenever you're watching this video. And I can then receive that energy virtually and channel more specific messages for your connection and for you specifically. I also do want to mention, as I do in all my readings, that this is a collective reading. So although I do try to get specific with my messages and channel as specifically as I possibly can, please know that many of these messages may not be for you, and they may be intended for someone else. That one card really wanted to just pop out there. Oh, whoa, okay, one more card. I was about to say that I was just going to flip over that one because I wasn't sure we were going to get any more cards right now. Let's see if we can get a third card. Okay, so I have three cards for you just starting out here today. Deep grounding breath. It's been a very energetically powerful yet intense season. So I hope you're all doing well. I hope you're all caring for yourselves. And let's get into these messages. Okay, the first card that I flipped over was anxiety in the upright position. I just heard there's something worrying you. And okay, so this worry that I'm channeling right now, this isn't an ordinary anxiety, like you're a little bit stressed about something. This is something that someone that I'm connecting with or someone's twin flame is seriously dwelling on. This is something that's causing them sleepless nights, could even be causing them physical tension, could be causing them to feel, for some reason I heard like stomach aches, like someone's stomach hurts or someone's throat is closing up because of this anxiety. Now, I want to get some more specific information on what exactly this anxiety is related to. So I'm actually going to go to the Romance Angels deck and see if I can pull a few messages on this. So I want to know what this anxiety about. Who is feeling anxious? What are they feeling anxious about? Okay, two cards fell out. Let's see what we have here. Give your relationship a chance. Okay, for some reason I heard like second chances, but almost like I'm all out of second chances. I feel like I'm strongly feeling that for some person I'm connecting with. I feel like there's a divine feminine I'm connecting with who is feeling worn thin, feeling like she's been giving out chance after chance after chance. And like she feels almost like she's running on empty. I specifically see a woman who's feeling really, really anxious. And then I see a divine masculine who wants to ask. It's like, I just want one more chance. Wow, I'm getting goosebumps. Like, I just want one more chance to make this right. I'm not really quite sure what happened in this situation or how this will apply if it connects with you, but the second card that came out is heart-to-heart conversations. Honestly, discuss your feelings with each other. Yeah, guys. So I've been channeling this just general collective energy for twin flames the last few days of an emotional and energetic breakthrough. Now, I know it's going to vary depending on your circumstances and situation, so this won't connect with everyone, but I'm feeling that ego is really breaking down at this time, especially for many divine masculines. I feel like there is an ego death situation going on, which of course, many of you who are twin flames are very familiar with ego death. It is really when everything in our material world that doesn't align with our true soul self and life purpose on this planet begins to crumble. And it often looks very messy. It can feel deeply painful. It can feel like a time of mourning, grief, and it's usually very intense. And I do strongly feel a divine masculine going through this and like wanting this heart-to-heart conversation, but not being sure how to open up. I feel like, for some reason, I feel like the energies I'm connecting with, there was a divine masculine in this situation who was really closed off. I just saw like a closed door, like the divine feminine kept trying to open the door and he shut it. Specifically a door that could be connected even to some kind of childhood trauma, like don't go in that door, don't open that door because I don't want you to see what I keep locked behind that door, kind of metaphorically speaking. But I feel like this divine masculine may suddenly be, I just heard waking up. So this could be spiritually waking up or just like, I just see someone getting shaken awake, like having this intense wake up call. I don't feel like this is gentle. This is like an intense wake up call. I do want to know more information about what this is about, specifically with this potential wake up call the divine masculine is having. I feel like both counterparts might be experiencing anxiety for whatever energies I'm connecting with. Again, this won't be everyone, but I feel there's this mirrored anxiety, but it's manifesting differently. I feel like one party might be more vocal about the anxiety that they're feeling than the other might be more closed off. Can I get any more information about the divine masculine and what he's going through, potentially with this ego death situation? I also feel that there could be many emotions coming up during this time. I just saw a divine masculine actually crying, like secretly, trying to kind of hide his emotions, but then just feeling this outpouring of really intense emotion. Okay, so I had three cards come out here. Let's see what we have. Seventh chakra. Okay, so this moment, this pivotal moment that there's a divine masculine going through, this is a, I don't want to say it's the start of their spiritual awakening, because typically twin flames ignite that spiritual awakening experience either prior to meeting, just connecting through their energy, or when they meet for the first time. So I know that the situation is going to be different for everyone, but I am strongly feeling that what this divine masculine is going through is very, very connected to destroying all the remnants of ego in his life, everything that he's built up from an ego-based space, not from a soul space. And I do feel like for some of you, there are a lot of these facets of his life that were built from ego and not for soul, from soul. And these things are crumbling. And this has to do with this next leg in his spiritual awakening journey. So I have a feeling that it may have been ignited a while ago, but for some reason I heard resisting. I feel like there's a divine masculine who's actually been resisting his spiritual path, resisting his awakening. I heard you had a chance. For some reason I feel, and I also heard the word detour. So I kind of feel for the energies I'm connecting with, this divine masculine, I feel there was a divine feminine who was holding a lot of space for him, who gave him a lot of chances, who really held that space of unconditional love for him. But for whatever reason, from a space of ego or fear, I feel like this divine masculine made the wrong choice. He took a detour, so to speak, on his spiritual path. And because of this, I do, and this hasn't come up in the cards yet, but for some reason I'm strongly feeling the divine feminine may have withdrawn somehow in the physical. Either not communicated as frequently, pulled away, physically pulled away in some way. I feel like she may have done this to work on herself, to protect her energy in some way. But then the divine masculine in this situation felt that withdrawal of energy, and it was a wake-up call for him. He realized he'd taken this detour. He'd taken this wrong, well, of course, there is no wrong path, but he'd taken this path out of from fear, from ego. And I feel that he's feeling a lot of regret and now wishing he hadn't taken this path, wanting to open up, but not being sure how, because the divine masculine I'm connecting with, I feel very strongly he is someone who doesn't normally, it's like, isn't comfortable opening up emotionally. Now, this won't be everyone, just one of the energies I'm connecting with. So I know I spoke a lot on that seventh chakra card, but the next card I'm getting here is Angel of Balance. And I also got Healer of the Ages, but both of these cards are in the reverse position. So what this tells me is that the divine masculine I'm connecting with, yes, with seventh chakra, this ego death he is experiencing, this pain, this intensity, this longing now to, I just heard return back, to go back and to fix something that he feels like he's broken or something that he's done wrong. This is all part of his spiritual awakening journey. This is the next part of his path. However, I feel like during this time with Angel of Balance in the reverse, I just heard everything feels unbalanced without you. I do strongly feel a divine feminine here who may have been the so-called chaser, right? Kind of in that chaser energy, pushing, trying to make things work, trying to hold that space for him. But maybe again, a little bit overcompensating in her own right, not really fully stepping into her own power for a while. And then now she is stepping into her power. She's withdrawing from that chaser energy. She's truly returning her energy, love, care, and attention to herself. The divine masculine has felt that shift, and it's now been a wake-up call for him. Wow, so if you are the divine feminine I'm connecting with in this situation, I wish I could give you just the biggest hug right now, because I feel like you have made such a powerful, intense shift in your life, like through your energy, through some way that you have shifted your energy, like you have truly withdrawn from that space of chasing, of pushing. And you are truly learning to unconditionally love both yourself and others. And it's a beautiful thing. But anyway, with this Healer of Ages also in the reverse, I feel like I just heard all the pain is coming up at once. So I am going to reshuffle the deck to see if I can get more messages on that. What other messages can I channel from the Healer of the Ages in the reverse? What is all this pain that is coming up at once for the divine masculine? Fourth chakra. Oh my gosh, guys, I am getting this wave of energy. This is, of course, the heart chakra. So I asked, as you could hear, where the pain was, what pain was coming up. In the heart. I literally see a heart just breaking. I feel like there is a divine masculine whose heart is just breaking open. I heard breaking open with love, but also with regrets, because it's like this realization. I just heard I had everything when I had you. And I don't know if that connects to some situation in this lifetime that happened between you and your counterpart, or this could even be a past life situation. Because this divine masculine is getting very in tune with his intuition, with his spiritual side, I feel like he is now almost reconnecting with the eternity, the eternal nature of this connection, realizing this connection has carried with him through lifetime after lifetime after lifetime. And the realization of that, and the regret at not stepping up maybe in the past, in this lifetime, is just literally breaking this divine masculine's heart wide open. I feel, because for some reason I saw again the Angel of Balance in the reverse with this fourth chakra card, I also am sensing imbalances in the heart center. So for some of you, this could be manifesting as upper back or neck tension, even heart palpitations, racing heart, strange heart sensations, especially at night, guys. I have to say, just kind of off the cuff here, I personally have felt a lot of really powerful heart chakra sensations at night. So like heart racing at night when you're trying to sleep. And I've actually heard other twin flame YouTubers report this kind of thing recently as well, which makes me think this is a collective energy, this kind of heart chakra breaking open, teaching us how to unconditionally love in deeper, more profound ways. So do let me know in the comments if you've been experiencing that. Also, if you have been experiencing that, I would really recommend my twin flame heart chakra activation subliminal. So I didn't mention this in the beginning. Normally, I talk about my subliminals in the intro of these readings, but on my website, soundandsoulful.com, I have created over 100 subliminal affirmations tracks for all areas of life. So subliminals are designed to bypass the conscious filter of the mind and implant deep, lasting impressions on the subconscious mind, which is so vital because it's actually the subconscious mind that is a reflection of our energy field. So we can make really powerful energy shifts through the subconscious mind, through these unconscious affirmations that we can implant on the subconscious. So all of the subliminal meditations I recommend will be linked in the pinned comment and the description box under this video. You can try out any subliminal I recommend completely free for 7 days when you create a free trial account on my website. Okay, so divine masculine, heart chakra breaking open. And I actually heard that if you are a divine feminine who has been feeling really strange heart sensations I talked about earlier, but you're not really sure where it's coming from, this could actually be coming from your masculine. You could be feeling the energetic echoes, the effects of the shifts he is feeling in the heart center, because twin flames are, of course, extremely energetically connected. So when one twin is experiencing a profound shift or breaking open in a certain chakra center, the other might manifest the symptoms or sensations from that breaking open. Wow, guys, so much just in that first card in the initial spread. But I'm now going to flip over the second card that I pulled initially. So the second card is community in the upright position. Okay, so what I heard here is a divine feminine grounding herself, reconnecting with her community, specifically with family, with friends, with the loved ones, people outside of her twin flame. Or even with herself. I heard for some, this could even be reconnecting with her true self, centering herself, grounding herself. Now, for some of you, I feel like this is a word of advice. It's like, this is something that if you are a divine feminine who isn't doing this, could be really beneficial to you energetically and to your connection. But I actually heard detour again. Okay, this is a really strange message, so hang with me for this message. But I feel that there is a divine feminine who sees her divine masculine going through this spiritual awakening, this really profound shift. She wants to hold the space for him in unconditional love, but also she is feeling this intuitive pull to just really reconnect with herself, participate in self-care, withdraw her overfixation from this connection, from his energy, really focus on herself, even potentially focus on reconnecting with friends. I just heard simply like having fun, enjoying life again, grounding herself. But she almost is worried. It's like this anxiety is coming up here, thinking, if I do this, am I choosing that over my twin? If I choose to withdraw my fixation from this connection and return it to myself and to building this centering life, to having fun, to enjoying my life, is this a detour on my spiritual path? Wow, okay, so I feel like this is causing her anxiety, whoever I'm connecting with. But what I'm strongly hearing here is no, this is not a detour. This is actually you healing yourself, reconnecting with yourself, your true authentic self. And if this is your true twin, when you reconnect with yourself, when you energetically heal yourself, this actually causes your twin flame to shift, to heal as well. Wow, so really strong messages of a divine feminine stepping into her true power here through what might even look like a kind of, I just heard like a backdoor to healing. Like I feel whatever this divine feminine is doing, this might not even look like traditional, conventional spiritual healing. I feel this person is very spiritual and might do those things, meditate, listen to subliminals, do yoga, those kinds of things. But I actually feel like right now she is also integrating these kinds of literal just life enjoyment experiences, drinking her tea or coffee outside in the morning, reading, going to get maybe a massage or have a spa day or reconnect with family or friends, or like do these self-care things that are actually causing her to create these profound energetic shifts. And this is a very strange message, guys. Oh my gosh. Okay. So this is very convoluted, but I feel that this divine feminine actually might be thinking something is going wrong because she sees that her divine masculine is going through this waking up. I feel something came to light. I hope this comes up later. I feel something came to light in this connection where this divine masculine got shaken awake. There may have even been like a trigger moment, something that happened in your connection that caused the divine feminine to be pushed to withdraw, to return her energy to herself, to not focus so heavily on her masculine or this connection. This may have even looked like a falling out of some kind between her and the masculine. But what I'm hearing is she felt in this situation something was going wrong and decided, you know what, I'm just going to care about myself. I'm going to participate in self-care, live my life, reconnect with people I love, and not focus so heavily on this connection. And she was worried that in doing this, she was taking a detour. But the strange thing I'm picking up is that because she is doing all these things, caring for herself, reconnecting with herself, this is actually assisting her divine masculine in this spiritual awakening he's going through. It's like when she withdrew her energy from this situation and focused it on herself, she actually caused this really powerful shift within him that is causing this breaking open in his heart chakra, that is causing this ego death. And although it looks very messy, this is actually bringing very deep level healing and transformation to the masculine that has been pending for a long time, that has needed to happen for a long time. By the way, if you are this feminine I'm connecting with, I really do recommend my subliminal for the Awakened Divine Feminine, because this subliminal is really designed to return your energy to yourself, to create a very powerful divine feminine aura, a magnetic aura that naturally attracts and manifests deeper connection with the masculine, not as a result of chasing or fixating on this connection, but as a result of truly stepping into your effortlessly magnetic power. So this subliminal will be linked in the pinned comment and description box if you're interested. The third card I pulled here is the first chakra card in the upright position. Now, the funny thing about this card is it actually fell out of the deck. I think all three of these cards fell out of the deck. But with this card specifically, I remember seeing it and not being sure whether it was in the upright or the reverse position, which is really interesting because what this tells me is that this is actually a shifting energy. So this is the first chakra card in the upright position. I finally decided I thought it would be upright, but I thought at first it was reversed. So what this tells me, because of course the first chakra is connected with foundations, with roots, with building a strong core, a strong foundation. So what I heard is a foundation is being shaken, but through being shaken is being made stronger. So I know that's a very strange kind of energy, but what I'm really getting here is that there's been some kind of ego destroying, earth shaking, ground breaking kind of experience that either both or one counterpart has been going through. Again, I strongly feel the masculine has been really feeling it in earnest, but I think the feminine felt the effects of this as well. I just heard she felt the fallout of whatever. I feel like the feminine has been experiencing the fallout of whatever this divine masculine did or created or built or had in the physical, whether this was So there's something out of alignment that was out of alignment for the masculine, whether it's a third party karmic, an addiction, a job, there was something that had to come crashing down for him. And I feel the feminine did experience a little bit of energetic fallout from this, feeling a bit shaken by this experience, almost wondering if something is going wrong. But what this card is telling me is nothing is going wrong here. This foundation felt like it was shaking because that groundbreaking experience was necessary in order to clear the air for this new foundation to be built. This was an experience that was, I just for some reason saw the image of like, I don't even know much about farming, but like tilling a field, like uprooting the soil, the good soil, like underneath the topsoil or whatever. Again, bear with me. This image was just being channeled to me, but I don't really know much about this subject. But just tilling up the soil in order to plant something new. And Spirit is also reminding me that when you first plant this new thing, you aren't going to see the evidence of it at first. And I just heard this thing you're planting, it's your new intentions for this connection. It is your vision, not just yours, but shared. there's really this emphasis on a shared vision. I feel for a while it may have felt as though one side was really pulling the weight of the connection, or at least this is the perception. I feel like someone felt as though my shoulders are starting to feel heavy, so I feel like someone felt like there was too much on their shoulders, like they couldn't do it alone, so finally they just kind of dropped the reins, kind of withdrew energetically from this to work on themselves. But actually in doing this, it was a wake-up call to the other party in this connection. It caused this very groundbreaking, earth-shaking experience that then is now going to allow that metaphoric soil to be tilled, to be messed up, for lack of a better word, in order to plant something new. And I just also heard so many things had to be uprooted. And I feel that those things that had to be uprooted were, like we were talking about with the ego death, all of these facets and pieces and parts of life, of our lives, that were not in alignment with our true soul self. Through this ego death, these things are being uprooted. And I just heard, oh my gosh, guys, I got a really powerful, I know this image has just been going on and on, but I just keep channeling new things with it. So in this kind of farming image, I'm feeling that Spirit is saying these things had to be uprooted now, because if you had tried to plant this vision in this soil with weeds in it, the weeds would have choked out that plant before it had a chance to grow up into this full vision. So whatever, again, I just keep hearing coming to light. I feel like there is something that came to the light or came into the consciousness or the realization of the divine feminine or the masculine, but I'm feeling for many it's the feminine, about what the masculine was dealing with or going through, or some kind of addiction or third party situation or something going on in his life. And I am strongly feeling that as a result of this situation, the divine feminine or whoever I'm connecting with here really started to question, is there some kind of detour happening here? Is something going wrong here? Because I feel like my foundation with this person is being shaken. But what you're being told is this is actually all part of divine plan. Everything is happening in divine order with this thing coming to light, with this potential fallout, with this ego death. All of this is happening to clear space for that new perfect vision to be planted, and for it to have room to grow and to actually grow up to become what you truly want it to be, what you intended it to be on a soul level. Wow, really powerful messages. I'm going to see if I can get more information on this first chakra card, which, by the way, if you've been feeling this kind of core shaking, ground breaking kind of experience I've been describing, I would also really recommend my root chakra activation subliminal, because all of those kinds of energetic foundations are really first created and stored in the root chakra. So when we feel that instability or that feeling like our foundation is shaking, what we're experiencing is a lot of intensity or shifting happening in the root chakra. So this subliminal is really designed to assist you through that energetic experience and really activate the root chakra to its highest, highest vibrational state of being that will really allow you to create a stronger foundation with your twin. So that will be linked in the pinned comment and description. So what other information can I get about this foundation being shaken, about this root chakra card? What other messages can I bring forth for twin flames listening to this video, for anyone connecting with this reading? What else do twin flames need to know at this time? The cards are so quiet, and for some reason I kept feeling like the cards were literally stuck together. And I heard someone's twin flame like saying, we are stuck together, like we will always be connected. Maybe it's both on a soul level saying this to each other, or even I hear this like two twin flames saying this to each other on a soul level, but they aren't communicating that in the physical. I feel like in the physical, a lot are experiencing a lot of pain or even the separation or intensity. But on a soul level, it's like there's this message of, we've always been connected. We're always going to be connected no matter what happens. In fact, we planned this for our soul's greatest growth and evolution. For some reason, I heard, I feel like I'm losing you. And I heard it in a really pained male voice. Like a male voice that was extremely emotional. Yeah, the thinking man. So that message I just heard was coming from a divine masculine saying, I don't want to lose you, in this really emotional voice. I feel like this isn't something he actually said to his divine feminine, although it may have been said to her, but I actually do feel like this was said aloud. Like this is something he said to himself out loud. Like, I am so scared of losing you. I feel like he has been in a fight with his ego. I just heard that this fight has actually been going on for a long time, and now there's a lot coming to light, a lot coming to the surface, and this ego is finally being checked or being crumbled through this ego death experience. But I feel like this is really painful for him. It's like I just heard I'm now aware of the ways in which my ego has been keeping us apart. It's like, I feel the divine feminine has been seeing this for a long time, like seeing the ways that his ego has been inhibiting this connection, but he has been stubborn or like unaware of it. What else can I bring forth? Whoa, I just, as I was asking, that card just flew out. Door to romance. I just heard, oh, it's so funny because remember earlier I was talking about this divine masculine feeling like I don't want to open that door, like emotionally, because I feel there's a divine masculine who's actually scared to have any kind of authentic heart-to-heart conversation because he feels like if he opens that door, it's like, there's just going to be this overflow of emotion, and it's almost like he's afraid of how that will look, like damaging his masculinity or something, like making him feel like less of a man, just to put it bluntly, for crying, for opening up, for being emotional. But I just heard, I'm ready to open that door. I also saw the number 33, and I have been seeing so much of the number 333 lately. So if you've been seeing that number, that message might specifically be for you. But I also saw the indecision card. I actually feel this coming from the feminine. I'm kind of hearing a conversation emerge here where there's a masculine like, I'm now realizing the ways in which my ego held me back. I'm so scared of losing you. I'm aware that the ego that I allowed to control me in my life was actually preventing our connection, that I always kept you shut out, but I'm ready to open that door. But I'm almost worried that it's too late, that you've already locked that door. And on the other side, I see a divine feminine trying to decide something. I want to know what the divine feminine is trying to decide here. Okay, so the two cards that flew out were Goddess of the Moon and Patience. This divine feminine is trying to decide, or she thinks on some level that she's trying to decide between just stepping into her goddess power and just living her life and feeling like this powerful goddess, or being patient and waiting on her twin flame to do his healing work, waiting up on him. But now what I'm actually hearing is spirit coming in here and saying, you, through your human mind, think that these are two different choices. You think it's either I wait here, I be patient for him to do his healing work, I hold the space for him, or I go on, I step forward, I step into my power, I withdraw my fixation from this connection, focus it on myself, and just let this be whatever it's going to be. But what spirit is saying is that actually you have it kind of turned around here. And I don't mean this in any kind of like reprimanding way or anything like that. I totally deal with the same kinds of feelings and struggles internally. So I really empathize with whoever I'm channeling this message to. But the message that's coming across is kind of this message of, you're looking at this the wrong way. You think that somehow this is like actually a limiting belief that a divine feminine has and is dealing with, but I don't think she's aware that she's dealing with this. And the limiting belief is this, it's that in order to unconditionally love another person, you have to give away so much of yourself, so much of your power. You have to sacrifice. You have to be the martyr. But what I'm hearing is, in a twin flame connection, in this divine love connection, when you step into your true power, when you focus on yourself, when you truly do what brings you joy and pleasure, focus on being your most authentic, powerful, creative, loved and loving self, that is actually what results in deeper manifested physical connection with your twin flame. That is actually what holds the space for him to be able to do the work on himself, for him to be able to heal. And actually, whenever we overly fixate on this connection through that chaser energy, we are actually choking it out. We are constricting it. We think that we're holding the space for the masculine to heal, but we are actually keeping the energy stuck. We are actually holding the energy where it is instead of allowing it to transform. And the truth is, oh wow, this is a hard pill to swallow, but there's been a divine feminine doing this, thinking that she's just being the martyr, holding the space, holding the unconditionally loving space, being so patient. She thinks that she has been the martyr of the connection, but truly, she has actually been preventing the divine masculine from healing because she has been holding the energy where it is by overly fixating on him, by trying to force him to heal or change through her words or actions, through the things she's doing or saying or how she's pushing in the physical in this connection. She is actually energetically preventing things from transforming. And the reason she is doing this is because she is actually afraid of letting go. This divine feminine I'm connecting with may or may not be fully conscious of this, but she is dealing with some kind of a control issue here. Wow, I just got this wave of sadness from this feminine, like on an unconscious level, this feeling of, I'm afraid if I let go, I'll lose you forever. I'm afraid if I just leave you to do your healing work, withdraw my energy, focus it on myself, step into my power, I am afraid that you won't choose me in the end. There is a divine feminine here who thinks that she's holding the space for her masculine, that he is the one who needs to heal. But actually, she also has some healing work to do on herself, but it's not what she thinks. It's not by overly fixating on him or on this connection, but actually on withdrawing her fixation from him, allowing him the space and time to do his healing work, and fully returning her energy to herself, her attention to herself. Wow, that was a very powerful message that came through. I want to see if there's any other information I can get here. By the way, if you've been connecting with any of these feelings of anxiety, kind of instability, uncertainty, my all-time favorite subliminal I've created is my 7 chakra clearing. I personally have struggled a lot with feelings of uncertainty, insecurity, doubt, and this subliminal truly has transformed my life. It has helped me to ground my energy every day. I started listening to it in November, and since then, it's helped me to build this channel, to do this work, to really clear my mind and my energy and manifest everything that I've been desiring in life for years. So this subliminal is linked in the pinned comment and the description box under this video. I'm gonna see if I can just get any more messages here for the Twin Flame Collective. Can I bring forth any more messages for Twin Flames listening to this reading? What else do Twin Flames need to know at this time? That's funny, guys. So there was a card that actually flew out earlier that I had missed, and this is the Sun card. Of course, I don't believe in coincidences or accidents, so I feel there's a reason this card came out. This is the Sun card in reverse, so I'm going to read a little bit about this card because I'm just feeling a little guided to the guidebook. New beginnings. That is all I needed to know. New beginnings and great creativity. Yeah, okay, so there's a culmination point here. I just heard manifestation, culmination, things coming together. I heard things coming together even as they look like they're falling apart. I feel like many people connecting with this reading so far may be feeling as though their life is falling apart or their life with their twin flame, their connection is falling apart. But what Spirit is leaving us here with is a message of encouragement saying nothing is going wrong. Things aren't falling apart. They're actually coming together, and all of this needed to happen. This needed to come to the surface. The air needed to be cleared in order for you to plant this new vision with your person. I just heard delayed. I feel like there's someone here who might be attached through ego to timelines, thinking, this should happen within this period of months or years, or whatever the case may be. But I feel like you are really being guided to release this attachment to timelines, to understand that time is a construction of the collective ego. Time does not truly exist, especially when it comes to this connection. Time is not running out. It's not limited. Our idea, our concept of time limitation is just negative societal subconscious programming that we need to release. Everything is happening in perfect time. This connection is unfolding in perfect time. And whether you are the masculine or the feminine connecting with this, I'm feeling you being asked to trust in a more radical way than you've ever been asked to trust before, to trust the timing, the unfolding of your life and of this connection. So the last thing I'm going to do here is actually roll the letter initial dice and then potentially get a few more messages from some of the specific love-related decks. So these are sometimes the first, middle, or last initials of you or your person. Alternatively, sometimes these spell words. G-E-B-I-Y-A. J-T-C-E-O-Q. H-J-A-L-V. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to do is pull some cards from the Romance Angels and the Angel Answers deck. So what are some final messages I can bring forth for the Twin Flame Collective? What else do twin flames listening to this reading need to know at this time? Within the next few months. Okay, well now I'm really curious what's going to happen within the next few months. So I'm going back to the energy oracle cards. What is going to happen within the next few months? In the Twin Flame Collective, or in someone's connection who is listening to this reading. I just heard something that you've wanted, something you've been praying for, something you've been asking for, but that it might come from a different direction than you expected. That's kind of a strange message. But if you have something you've been trying to create or manifest in your life or in this relationship, I feel like you might feel like you're on a detour right now, like things are going wrong, but the thing you want might actually be coming from a different direction than you would expect or than you had planned through your human mind. Man holding a heart in the reverse position. For some reason, I specifically heard the hold on his heart is going to be released. So this won't apply to everyone, but if you have a divine masculine who has had a third party or some kind of external connection, I feel like this is going to either come to light or be released. It's like the hold that this person, this karmic or this situation, even an addiction or a thought pattern, this negative thing, this hold that this thing has on this divine masculine's heart is going to be released within a few months is the message that I'm getting. I think that actually was the message. So I'm going to go back and see if I can just pull a few more cards. Any final messages from the Romance Angels deck? And the final card that came out is engagement. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. Okay, so I have actually a message to bring through for this, kind of a deep message, but I feel someone connecting with this. This card might not be what you think. So for some of you, yes, you could be in a relationship with your twin flame, and this could be an actual engagement, as we think of an engagement, you know, with a ring, a wedding, all of that that's coming. But for most of you, what I'm actually hearing is your ego believes that an engagement, or that this engagement that you desire, is a ring, is a physical commitment, a manifested commitment, something visible. But what spirit is saying is, and I even hear actually this person might be looking through Instagram, Facebook, seeing their friends get engaged or have these like loving manifested relationships. And I hear spirit saying, the love that you have with this person is more profound, deep, and eternal than most people ever experience in their physical lifetime here on earth. This is a divine love connection. Your ego thinks the engagement you want is a proposal, a ring, a wedding. And so what spirit is saying is they're not saying that those things can't come or won't come, because of course it's natural for those physical manifestations of this connection to happen, to follow, to unfold. But the point here is the engagement that you truly desire is emotional engagement, energetic engagement, commitment to healing, not just this physical manifested commitment, like I'm wearing a ring, I'm connected to this person, but a deep level commitment to ultimate spiritual growth and expansion, emotional healing, spiritual healing. That is the true engagement that you desire and intended with one another. And in order, because you are a twin flame, and this is a very intense connection, in order for you and your twin to sustain those physical manifested things you want, whether it's a literal engagement, a wedding, a marriage, a family, whatever it might be for you, but in order for you to sustain those things, the emotional engagement has to be there first. The energetic commitment, the emotional commitment. And that is what you are being guided into right now. That is what is being cultivated right now. So release your timelines and ego-based expectations about what this is supposed to look like or when it is supposed to happen, especially those expectations based on what you see from other people's relationships on social media. I just heard your relationship isn't like theirs. Your twin flame connection isn't like theirs, and theirs is not what it appears to be. Most people, I'm getting this message of like most people present this very literal physical engagement. They show off their engagement ring or their wedding or their family. But most people are also deeply unhappy and unfulfilled in these very ego-based love connections. You are learning true unconditional love in order to radiate that to all of the planet, in order to uplift human consciousness to a different level of understanding of what love and relationships are supposed to be, to look like, to feel like. Wow, very, very powerful message. I feel like that's a perfect place to end this reading. Thank you so much for joining me today in this reading. I truly hope each and every one of you listening this far found some kind of message here that connects with you or resonates with you in some way. All of the subliminals I recommended during this reading are linked below in the pinned comment and description box under this video. The subliminals I recommended were the Awakened Divine Feminine, the Root Chakra Activation, the Twin Flame Heart Chakra Activation, and the Seven Chakra Clearing. So if any of those resonate with you or pique your interest, be sure to click the links below this video to explore more about how you can begin using subliminals to create powerful shifts in your energy that will then create immense shifts and changes in your twin flame connection as well. Because of course, this is a very energy-based, spiritual-based, soul-based connection. So by shifting your energy, your twin flame instantaneously feels those shifts. So again, you can try any subliminal I've created free for 7 days when you create a free trial account on my website, soundandsoulful.com. Please do subscribe to this channel if I resonate with you. Join our community of like-minded, conscious, creative beings here on YouTube. You can also follow me on Instagram at magnetizeyourself, where I post high vibrational content and twin flame energy readings, messages on a daily basis, or at least that is the new posting schedule I am getting into. So thank you so much again for being here. Take care of yourself energetically, physically during this very intense time. I am so grateful for this beautiful community we've created here together, and I'm grateful to you wherever you are listening to this for contributing your energy to this reading. You are a powerful co-creator on this channel, in this space, and I love each and every one of you. Have a beautiful rest of your day, and I will talk to you again in the next reading.